Today we're taking a look at the NFL matches, which are happening on Friday, August 27, 2021, and giving you match breakdowns, betting tips and predictions in general on these games. Welcome back to High Stakes, let's get straight into it. Also, don't forget to subscribe to get notified as soon as we release these sport prediction videos, and if you would like more betting tips and predictions, then check out our Patreon in the link down below. Our new Patreon is a way for us to help you improve your chances of making more money. 5 plans are available for each and every one of you. You can get 30 extra betting picks all the way up to 270 extra betting picks per month. Stop wasting hours of your time searching for bad betting advice that ends up costing you a lot of money. Join the High Stakes Patreon now and get the best betting picks and advice. Indianapolis Colts at Detroit Lions. The Colts are road favorites with an implied win probability of 64.29%. Their minus 180 money line odds can be expressed as a fraction of 5/9 or a decimal of 1.56. The Lions plus 145 odds represent an implied win probability of 40.82%. The Indianapolis Colts got some good news this week, with Carson Wentz returning to practice, although he won't be playing at all in this game. The Colts have won each of their first 2 games of the preseason, including the last game against the Minnesota Vikings. In the last game, Sam Ellinger had some issues under center, but Jacob Eason looked good. Eason completed 16 of his 27 passes for 132 yards. In the last game, the running game had a little bit of an issue getting going. The defense was strong against the Minnesota Vikings, giving up only 10 points, and in this game, if they want to come away with a victory, it's going to be about the defense locking down early. The Colts and Lions must combine to score 33 or more points for a bet on the over 32.5 to cash. A total of 32 or fewer points is a win for the under. The odds price the over as the more likely result on the projected total. My betting advice for that game is to pick the Indianapolis Colts. Pittsburgh Steelers vs. Carolina Panthers. Juju Smith-Schuster saw his most action of the preseason, with 5 catches for 59 yards, while Eric Ebron caught 4 passes for 59 yards. Rookie Pat Freiermuth was impressive with 2 catches, both touchdown catches, for 19 yards. Against the Panthers, the Steelers have already said Roethlisberger and Rudolph won't play, so Haskins will be getting a lot of playing time under center, along with Josh Dobbs. The Steelers are expected to sit their starters as they rest them up for the first game of the regular season. The Carolina Panthers are still searching for their first win of the NFL preseason, as the Panthers fell to 0-2 after being defeated by the Baltimore Ravens, 23, this past Saturday. Carolina took an early 3-0 lead on a 41-yard FG by Joey Sly. However, the Panthers' offense had trouble generating anything else the rest of the way, and could not fight back after Baltimore took a 10-3 lead going into the fourth quarter. Carolina was outgained by Baltimore by a 354-189 margin, and had only 8 first downs in the loss. Offensively, Carolina was led by QB Will Grier, who completed 11 of 14 passes for 144 yards. My betting advice for that game is to pick Carolina Panthers. Philadelphia Eagles vs. New York Jets. Hurts lost his chance to play with dynamic rookie wide receiver Devonta Smith. Smith did not play in the preseason opener because of a knee injury, but returned to limited action this week in drills. The Eagles moved up 2 spots in the first round to select the reigning Heisman Trophy winner, with a number 10 overall pick. You can expect both of them in action for this final preseason game against the Jets. Since they've had limited snaps together in the preseason, Hurts and Smith will be out there for the majority of the first half on Friday. The New York Jets have had quite the successful preseason so far, as they are currently 2-0. The Jets defeated the Green Bay Packers by the final score of 23-14 at Lambeau Field. The Jets have made it clear that number 2 overall pick Zach Wilson is going to be the number 1 quarterback on the team from the get-go. Wilson had a fantastic showing in his last game against Green Bay, throwing for 128 yards on 9/11 passing and 2 passing touchdowns. My betting advice for that game is to pick Philadelphia Eagles. Quick reminder, you can get 125% cash back bonus on your first deposit on our partner Sportsbook BetUS after you open an account using our link down below and use our promo code HIGHSTAKES when making your deposit. Minnesota Vikings vs. Kansas City Chiefs. The Vikings will be looking to wake up offensively with their final preseason game up next on Friday. However, this game will be taking place on the road, so Minnesota will have to travel for the first time this season. The Kansas City Chiefs, who have won each of their two games in the preseason. In the last game against the Arizona Cardinals, the Chiefs were able to come away with a 17-10 victory. Patrick Mahomes played a good amount of the last game, completing 10 of his 18 passes for 78 yards and an interception. Shane Buechel completed 9 of his 11 passes for 115 yards, 1 touchdown, and 1 interception. Anthony Gordon also completed 7 of his 7 passes for 42 yards. There is a battle for the backup quarterback behind Mahomes, and that will be the battle in this one. Minnesota's offense will be led by quarterback Kirk Cousins, who looked underwhelming in the second preseason game. In that game, he completed 5 of his 7 pass attempts for just 23 passing yards, while also getting sacked once. However, since this is the preseason, he will most likely play for a maximum of 1 quarter. My betting advice for that game is to pick Kansas City Chiefs. The Green Bay Packers and the Buffalo Bills meet Saturday in NFL preseason action from Bills Stadium. This will be the third and final preseason game for both teams. Green Bay is 0-2, so far following losses to the Texans and Jets. As for Buffalo, they've beaten the Lions and Bears in exhibition play thus far. Check back all season long for free NFL picks at Sports Chat Place. For the Bills, Mitchell Trubisky lit it up against his old Bears team, but don't expect him to show the same fire. He clearly had a chip on his shoulder in that matchup, and won't have the same advantage of knowing how the Chicago defense operates. Furthermore, Buffalo's run game has been lackluster, and it's hard to trust Trubisky, Davis Webb, and Jake Fromm to cover the spread against anybody. Green Bay fell behind the Texans 13-7 in the first half of their opener, ultimately falling 26-7, after failing to score from there. QB Jordan Love put up 122 yards and a score on 12 of 17 passing, while Dexter Williams led the rush on 32 yards from 4 carries. The Green Bay Packers round off their NFL preseason with a trip to Buffalo, and despite 2 poor showings, there could be value in taking the road team against the spread. Green Bay has been well beaten by 2 teams that are expected to be among the worst in the league in Houston and the Jets, but backup QB Kurt Benkert looked a lot sharper against that mean Jets defense, and could have some success against Buffalo. The Packers have struggled to establish the run in their opening 2 games, but with roster cuts on the horizon, these players will know that they need to show up if they are to secure a spot. In Game 2 versus the Jets, the Packers had a 17-14 deficit heading into the break, but again couldn't score in the second half with a 23-14 result. Kurt Benkert went 18 of 25 with 151 yards, 1 TD and 1 interception. Patrick Taylor had 48 yards on 8 carries to lead the rush. My betting advice for that game is to pick the Packers. Good luck to all of you. That's it for this video. Stay tuned and stay safe for the next betting tips and advice.